So I saw this very interesting question on Reddit a few weeks ago, and it is about ranking values into tiers, or maybe it's better to say ranking numbers into groups. So let's look at the requirements. The smallest 12 values in column D become rank 1. The next 12 smallest numbers or averages become rank 2. And we want a very simple way to do this. So let's go over here and I'll show you two steps that will accomplish this. So we have our three columns of numbers. We have column D with our averages, always averaging the three numbers to the left. Step number one is going to be this. We want to rank these numbers, compare each of these individual numbers with everything, all the other numbers in the group. So let's unhide this, and we're going to take this value right here, the number 5. Click in the formula bar, and we're comparing D6, which is this number here, the 379.33, with all the other numbers in column D. So this is the number, comparing it to all of these values, D6 to D48. And over here in order, we're putting a number 1 because we want the smallest number to have a number 1. So let's look down here. 209 is the smallest value in column D, or within this range of numbers here. That's why it gets a number 1. It would be the same thing as putting a small. If I went up here and did small of this range, it would be 209. So this gets a number 1. Number 2 is down here. 270 is the second smallest. But this is individually ranking all the numbers in column E. We want to put them into groups of 12. The 12 smallest are group number 1. So that's the next step here. We have to use this match function. I'm going to go back into here. This time we're going to go into this cell and click on the formula bar, or I could also press the F2 key to get us there, but let's do this. Our lookup value is now E8. The rank, this 27 is the rank of the number to the left, 603.33. So it is the 27th smallest number, this guy here, within that range in column D. But we want to take this number 27, and we know it's not within our lookup array. We know that the 27 is not in here. But because we have a true over here for our match type, true allows you to do binning. Binning is basically this, saying, hey, is that 27 greater than or equal to 1 but less than 13? If it is, it's a number 1. So if it was a 6, we would get number 1. Is it greater than or equal to 13 less than 25? That would be a number 2. In this case, though, it is greater than or equal to 25, less than 37. That's why we get a 3 right here in this cell. So this is called binning when you put the true over here. Now, most of the time, almost always, if it's a match function or a VLOOKUP, you're going to be putting a false or a zero. That's very important not to forget. Most of the time, you're looking for an exact match, you would put false or zero. But here we are doing binning, comparing this E8 value, the 27, with each pair of numbers here, going from left to right. Small number always getting the number getting larger as we move to the right. So that is how this works. The thing is, we think we're done, but we should always do one final step. We should always double check the results. Remember, the 12 smallest numbers should there should be 12 of them, and they should be rank number 1. So if we look in here, there should be 12 ones, and it should be all the smallest numbers. So here I've done a count if function, and I say, okay, this is our group numbers. All the individual values in column D now have a group number, groups of 12. That's our range, and this is our number. How many have a number 1? And we're counting. Same thing here, how many of these numbers in column F have a 2, and all the way down. Now, that's basically it. But this thing here, if you haven't seen this before, our lookup array, that's actually an array constant. So if you haven't seen this before with those special brackets at the beginning and at the end, if you prefer to not have it all in a cell here, well, we have a couple of options. So that's going to be actually solution number 3. Solution number 2 is just simply taking these two steps here and putting it into one formula. So instead of over here saying, hey, take the rank from column E, over here, it's just all together in one little step. But what if we don't want to have these this hard-coded array constant? What if you want to have it in a range over here like that to make it maybe for some people a little bit easier to change? What if you want to have 1 to 6 and then 6 to 31, make them sort of uneven sizes. Well, we can easily do that. Let's take this formula. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to put it over here, paste it. And now this lookup array, I'm going to carefully highlight this, press delete, go over here. Now I'm going to highlight those values. This is set up as a table. Press the enter key, take this, and drag it down. Well, actually, there's a blank column here, so we can't drag this down. I'm just going to cheat a little bit. I'm going to put in the letter A. Now Excel thinks this is all one range. I'm going to drag this all the way down and then remove that. So we see that we get the exact same values in column J as column H as column F. So various ways to do this, but sometimes we can take something that looks complicated and simplify it into just a couple of steps to solve it.